This video is sponsored by Defromon. Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. A few months ago, DF Robot got in touch with me and offered to sponsor some things for some of my future projects. After a few days of OSINT and general investigation to make sure that I was not just being scammed or phished, I took the offer and picked the DF Robot Beginner Kit compatible with Arduino, together with other components that I would need for some of my future projects. This is going to be the first video on a new playlist that I specifically created for the DF Robot Beginner Kit, where I would only use the components included inside on every project as a challenge for myself. Today we're going to unbox it to see what things are included inside and do a quick test. Let's go! So here's the package that contains the starter kit together with the modules for some of my future projects. DF Robot graciously sent these things to me for free, including these stickers which I asked for on a whim. Really glad that they have included it. These are the modules for another video. And finally, the DF Robot Beginner Kit. Well, let's open it up then! Right off the bat, we can see the project cards. Basically, these are sample projects that we can do. It starts from the very basic and progresses to an intermediate-ish level, which I think would be really helpful for educators to use. At the front of each project card is the project name and wiring diagram. Here we can see that the LED is connected to ground via a jumper cable and to digital pin 13 via a jumper cable as well, with a 220 ohm resistor between them. Now, moving on to the back side of the project card, we can see the components list, which lists what components are required in order for us to do the sample project. It says that we would need two male-to-male jumper cables, a 220 ohm resistor, and a 5mm LED. Strangely enough, the DF Arduino and prototyping shield are not included. At first, I thought that they should have been labeled or at least mentioned here as well, but as we move on to the next part of the video, we would see why it's not that necessary. Anyway, here are the sample projects that are included, starting from Project 1, blinking an LED, SOS beacon, traffic light, fading light, RGB LED, alarm, temperature alarm, detecting vibration, auto light, moving a servo, interacting or controlling a servo, RGB light dimmer, motor fan, infrared controlled light, and lastly, infrared controlled LED matrix. After that, here we have a cardboard divider that has the link for the Arduino IDE installer, which would take us directly to Arduino's website where we can download it. The DF Robot website, where we can download a very comprehensive tutorial PDF that contains all the projects from the project cards together with their corresponding codes plus a few more interesting things. It can be found on the Beginner Kit's product page, by the way. We can think of the project cards as questionnaires for the students to answer by coming up with a usable code, or remembering how to use and implement the codes to make the circuit function. I mean, provided that they already know the basics, of course. And then, the PDF would serve as the guide for educators to confirm if what they did was correct or not. Kind of like a lesson plan or an answer sheet. And finally, DF Robot's social media accounts. Onto the left side, we have the parts list or list of things that are included in the kit. One DF Arduino Uno R3 MCU, one prototyping shield, 30 pieces male-to-male jumper cables, 10 pieces female-to-male jumper cables, 20 pieces 220 ohm resistors, 20 pieces 4.7 k ohm resistors, 20 pieces 10 k ohm resistors, 20 pieces 1 k ohm resistors, 9 pieces of 5mm LEDs, 1 RGB LED, 1 IR receiver, 4 mini push buttons, 1 ambient light sensor, 2 tilt switch sensors, 1 piece 8 segment LED, 1 LM35 temperature sensor, 1 relay, 1 buzzer, 1 fan, 1 piece 130 motor, not really sure what that is, 3 pieces 10k potentiometers, 1 micro servo, 1 mini controller, not really sure what that is either, 1 piece 6AA battery holder, 1 USB or data cable, and last but not the least, 1 piece crystal solderless breadboard. Now, to verify if the items included are complete and see which item or component is which and what they look like, here they are. This is the micro servo, mini IR remote controller. Ah, so this is the mini controller from the parts list. This is the USB or data cable. So apparently, this is the 130 motor. Never thought that it was called that, honestly. I just call it a Tamiya motor or a small DC motor. Learn something new every day, eh? 5mm LED, 8-segment LED, 220 ohm resistor, RGB LED, 10K potentiometers. This is the fan or fan blade, female to male jumper cables, 10K ohm resistors, ambient light sensor, 4.7K ohm resistors, buzzer, relay, male to male jumper cables, LM35 temperature sensor, IR receiver, tilt switch sensor, 1K ohm resistors, mini push buttons, the prototyping shield. As you can see, the small breadboard is not yet attached to it. I believe it was on purpose so that we would have a choice on whether to use the breadboard or not. The 6 AA battery holder, the solderless breadboard which was supposed to be a crystal one. I guess they ran out. Doesn't matter anyway, still the breadboard. And finally, the DF Arduino Uno R3. DF Robot's version of the Arduino Uno. Alrighty then, for us to do a quick test, let's just go with making the onboard LED blink. Making the onboard LED blink is the easiest way to test a board or module, and it's almost always the first thing to do or try when you buy a new board. Alright, let's launch the Arduino IDE. Click on File, Examples, Basics, and Blink. As you can see here, the sample code itself explains what the code does and how the code works. And there we have it! Test is done! Taking a look at its product page, we can see that at the time of writing my script, it's currently on sale. Here are some of the comparisons between a cheaper alternative kit and the DF Robot kit, which I'd say is pretty much true because I also own the cheaper alternative. Here is the course outline. We can download the PDF by clicking the Getting Started Tutorial hyperlink. I have already downloaded it, so I'm not going to download it again. Here are some of the contents of the PDF. This is the course structure. Project cards, basically what I've said earlier. Apparently, it has a mobile app as well, which could be really helpful since you can still program stuff even without a computer and just by using your phone. For a quick look, I've downloaded it to my phone and here it is. The app is from Bluino Electronics. Here are the sample projects, some introductions of the Arduino Uno and how to install and use the IDE. Keep in mind that these are also on the PDF. The only difference is that you can use the app to upload the code to the DF Arduino by using your mobile phone. Going back to the product page, the PDF is also available in 3 languages, English, Korean, and Russian. Now let's take a look at the wiki page. Seems like this is the one on the PDF as well. Beginner kit tutorial is just a PDF. Sample code is a compressed or zipped folder that contains all the codes for each project. The GitHub repository contains all of the 2 resources, the PDF and the sample codes. The last hyperlink is just press related content and shipping list is just the parts list from before. Now, since I've mentioned this a lot throughout the video already, why don't we take a look at the PDF as well? Right after opening the PDF, we could see that it has a lot of pages, 133 to be exact. It could definitely feel overwhelming, but don't be scared. As can be seen on the second page, most of what occupy the pages are blank spaces and big fonts. See? So before we embark on a journey to learn something new, in this case, programming an Arduino, first and foremost, we have to know what it is. I think page 2 explained it very well. Of course, knowing the history of the thing that we would use would also be cool. I mean, back in computer class, we've learned that Charles Babbage was the inventor of the first automatic digital computer. Right? Now, a lot of us use computers because of the mad lad who invented it. Same thing goes for the Arduino. We should give credit where credit is due and of course, support the OGs who have decided to make everything open source despite the fact that it could lose them money. I have included a link of a blog post by one of the OGs, Massimo Banzi, in the description below. I highly suggest checking it out. It's really informative. Just below Arduino's history is a sort of map of the DF Arduino Uno. It states what the most relevant parts of the board are called without being too in-depth. Remember, this is for beginners and most beginners would only need to focus on these things. Well, that's just what I think at least. On page 4, we have a step-by-step guide on how to install the Arduino IDE, from where to download the installer to driver installations. Below it is the guide on how to upload our very first code. After that, on page 12, the project tutorial starts. Each project tutorial on the PDF includes a brief explanation on what each project does, what are the components needed, how to set up the hardware, wiring diagram, the sampled code, how the code works, definitions of terms, what the most relevant components does, and some projects also have exercises or homeworks for students to do after class, which is really neat. In my honest opinion, I think this is one of the best Arduino-compatible beginner kits on the market. Its superb packaging and number of resources really takes the cake. Everything has its own resealable plastic bag and everything is labeled properly, which makes it easier for beginners. Here's the thing. Labels are often overlooked when it comes to these things, even though they are really necessary. That's why I was really glad that everything was properly labeled on this kit. Most of the time, cheaper alternatives only include a small picture of the components with their names at the back of the product paper, like this one. This takes me back to when I bought my first starter kit. The year was 2018. I bought the cheap one because I didn't know better. It made me spend hours googling the names and pictures at the back of the product paper just to verify what component they are. I mean, they are starter kits for beginners. Each component should at least be labeled properly because most beginners won't know what each component is called just by how they look right off the bat. Another thing to think about when buying a beginner starter kit is its resources. The previous kit that I had doesn't have any. This kit, however, has a lot of resources. From GitHub, Wiki, the PDF, collection of sample codes, and of course, the user-provided or contributed DF Robot app. The downloadable PDF is one of the best things that DF Robot has provided for this kit. It contains a lot of information that's really useful for anyone who wants to start learning Arduino programming. I am aware that the information in the PDF can also be found on numerous other sources, mainly on Arduino's official website. However, having everything available in one place saves us time because we don't have to search for anything. Everything is already neatly packed in the PDF. Plus, we can still view the PDF even without internet connection. DF Robot is also one of Arduino's official distributors, which I think is cool. That way, we can make sure that the Arduino boards, modules, and sensors that they sell are all legitimate and not counterfeits. They also manufacture and sell their own Arduino clone boards, which I really like because they're black. By the way, to add more videos to this new playlist, I'm planning to do the included sample projects as well and try to do them with a beginner's perspective. We'd go through each project while following the guides on the PDF. So yeah, that's all for today, guys. Thanks for watching and see you again next week. Maybe.